You might think consciousness is pretty well our starting point. It's the thing we know best. It's all of us are surrounded by our consciousness. I mean, we have 100 billion neurons in our head interacting like a giant computer, if you like. Processing inputs, producing outputs. But we know we're not just giant robots. We actually have subjective conscious experience on the inside. There's something it feels like to be me. I quite like the idea that somehow information by its very nature has two aspects. There's a physical aspect that you might find in computers and in the brain, but there's also a subjective or experiential side of information, and that's what we find in consciousness.
Hey! Knock it off.
Complex information processing like in a human, complex consciousness. Simple information processing like you might find in an earthworm, then simpler consciousness. Any amount of information processing gives you some degree of consciousness. Even a molecule or a particle has a very small amount of information processing. So I at least don't rule out the idea that there's some basic kind of consciousness all the way down.
Damn it!
You're gonna miss.
Shut up.
You're gonna miss.
Damn it!
Let me try.
You're too drunk.
Come on. No way. Killing a dude's cat is cold.
Hey, that way now. Let's get some more beer.
Well, I know at least one human is conscious, and I tend to suppose that other humans are conscious as well, but then how far does it extend? Are apes conscious? Are mice conscious? Are flies conscious? I mean, it's very natural for us to recognize consciousness in certain animals. Anything with eyes, for example, it's almost irresistible to attribute consciousness to us. There it is, it's looking back at us. I can see the spark behind its eyes. We don't get much in the way of empathy for an insect. We can imagine being confronted with a fly that was blown up to human size. Now, this might be kind of scary and kind of weird, but at the same time, if I was looking directly into that fly's eyes, it might be hard not to see it as part of this circle of moral concerns. If it ever came to the day where we could actually take up a fly's perspective and see what it's like to be a fly from the fly's perspective, you know, mainlining a fly's consciousness. It might be hard from that moment on to just spot flies as casually as we do right now. question arises, what matters here? Is it the squishy human biology, or is it something more like the organization, or more like the information processing? Today's computers, if there's any consciousness at all, it's probably something pretty simple and pretty unintelligent. Some background flicker or bits.
Our lucky day.
Are you guys looking for me? Or...
Well, he's a real shithole, you know that?
What?
Seriously, what do you even do here?
I fix things.
Shut up, right there! What is that stuff, huh?
Waste. It's waste. Whose waste? Is that your waste?
Is that Miss K's waste?
No.
Eat it.
What? No.
Eat it.
Come on, you're the man. Why don't you just eat Miss Kitty's waste?
Doing
this. Eat it.
Look. Oh! I said eat it.
Hey, dude, check it out.
No, wait.
Hold it!
No, 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 no!
Oh, look at this place.
right now where the ancient Greeks were in the study of matter, or where Descartes was in thinking about biology. We hadn't had, you know, Newton hadn't come along yet, or Darwin hadn't come along yet. As computers become more intelligent than us, they'll be processing information in more integrated, more creative ways. It's even possible they'll move to degrees or levels of consciousness that we can't even conceive of. I don't see why there shouldn't be this kind of brain-computer interface that may well have the effect of extending ourselves. There's nothing magic about the skull as the boundary of the person. That's not where the mind stops and the rest of the world begins. Maybe from a God's eye point of view, space, time, and consciousness are all bound up at a more fundamental level. But, you know, for now, nobody knows the answer to that question.
Subscribe to Dust for new sci-fi every week.